All right, well, let's take it to the guy ranked 15th in our overall dynasty wide receiver rankings to this point. T.Y. Hilton had a down year. Nobody saw this Andrew Luck thing coming out of nowhere. We thought he might miss a few games. They didn't put him on the PUP list. We were like, all right. And then all of a sudden they trade for Brissett, and that's pretty much history. And now there's even cloud moving forward on whether Andrew Luck, which I'm sure he's probably going to be just fine. I think he went over to Europe, got some stem cell rejuvenation done. Hopefully that shoulder is good to go and he doesn't need any more surgery. But for the year that T.Y. had, which he didn't crack 1,000 yards, he only had 4 touchdowns, 57 catches, certainly not up to T.Y.'s standard and average. And it warrants dropping him a few spots here, I think. And it also, we mentioned it a little bit before, where he's 28. And you look at these rankings and you see all these young dudes. We just talked about all these super young dudes. And now T.Y.'s there at 28. Sometimes that's enough for people to just be out, and they don't want the age. But I mean, that's dumb. Don't be like that. But it does drop him down here to 15. But I mean, he's still a great player.
Well, and you could be playing into some more, again, subconscious kind of recency bias about, you know, what T.Y. Hilton did. And like you said, there's questions at the quarterback positions. There's questions at the coaching position here.
Right.
There's questions
ownership
from an organization standpoint. The Colts are just miserable.
I mean, Indianapolis
right now
is suspect in general.
Yes,
the city.
It's just very suspect city in general.
The Indy 500 is freaking awesome, but outside of that.
But, you know, you had T.Y. had glimmers and glimpses this year of what he does for you. But, it, you know, you weren't getting your standard T.Y. season out of him this year. And it's a little bit of a bummer. But you would imagine he'll bounce right back if Luck comes back and should come back. I believe he'll be
right.
All right. You go get a little stem cell action, like you said. And
work for Kobe Bryant.
Should be good to go.
Yeah.
But, you know. Well, the age thing is an easy reason, and the recency bias, both easy reasons to bump this guy down at the even 15 here, and he could easily be back up in 9, 8, 7. Really, you know, if he wanted
if
to,
Luck
be.
Came back and crushes next year. Yeah, he could jump up,
no doubt,
definitely into the top
10.
And
the dude just turned 28. In November, he did just turn 28, so it's easy to look at 28 versus 24 on another guy and be
right.
Like, oh, that's a huge difference, but you know.
28.1
some of these other guys we were talking about, their feistiness and their ability to, you know, play through contact and just, you know, see them get gimped up and they come back on the field. Well, T.Y. Hilton's 5'9", 178, soaking wet, but he's missed 2 games in his entire career.
Solid
okay?
stat.
So this man is out there playing. Casey and I were talking the other night on the phone about these guys, and like T.Y. Hilton is not your Tyreek Hill where he's going to be running a bunch of jet sweeps and returning punts. But when T.Y. Hilton is out there and got a quarterback that can hit him accurately, a lot of times when he catches a pass, he doesn't even get touched. He's so fast and so slippery. He's one of the most elusive guys, and is you don't really even see him having to juke people because he's joystick fast.
When he gets the ball in his hands and the camera sees him, he had already done his dirty work, so you don't even see that half
right.
the time because he's just 3 steps ahead of the guy when he catches
T.Y.
it.
T.Y. Hilton is ridiculous.
Let me get that sky cam all the time.
And it was a huge drop-off in numbers this year. He's coming off of a 91 catch, 1,450-yard. He led the league in receiving the year before last.
Yep.
Yeah. You know? Andrew Luck literally wore his shoulder out throwing it to him.
Right.
Needed surgery.
Yeah, so the T.Y. Hilton – the love for T.Y. Hilton you have to drop him down a list a little bit, but you need to love what he's done and what he can still do. This cat is a ridiculously good football player. And just like everything you just said, Jay Wayne, if you had any inclination of the Luck injury being as bad as it was, you would have not had T.Y. Hilton ranked in the top 10 of wide receivers last year. But you did have him ranked there because he had earned it. And there's a lot of ups and downs in this game, and a lot of people, you know, you're lost seasons. And look what Todd Gurley did this year after having just a horrible season the year before.
Sure.
So the Colts, I think down to most men on the team didn't realize what was going on with Luck. And it just – the tires fell off. And the only thing that – they can be excited about is the fact that they picked up Brissett for really cheap and he actually looks like a decent quarterback. I was very impressed. You got to imagine Brissett goes over there to a team who, when Peyton Manning left, they were bad enough to earn the first pick in the draft. The timing was everything for them to pick up Luck. Luck goes out. Who they got no good. They have hardly.
They had one. They played one game with Tolzien as the starter.
I think they had negative yards. I think they had negative yards with Tolzien.
Whole team's gonna quit if this keeps up, man. So nobody's going out on the field. Yeah.
Nobody's taking the field. So they bring in Brissett mid season, and he comes out there and he looks legit. So there's
mid preseason, right?
That was second week. Mid-season, and Brissett comes out there and he looks like a legit quarterback. So obviously you're thinking that, you know, the owner of the Colts, who none of us believe anymore at this point, but he says Luck will be out there playing, he's staying on the team. So the upside is T.Y. Hilton gets Luck back next year and he crushes again, and that's what we hope for. But you have to knock him down the list due to age, like we said, and just the question marks about the guy tossing him the ball. And the rough part is I could see another season of, what's going on with the Colts over there situation. Maybe Luck doesn't come back super healthy. You got to start thinking about that. And if it gets any farther down the line and there's any more clarity on the potential for just another horrible season for the Indianapolis, then maybe T.Y.'s value continues to drop down the board and he becomes a huge value, because he's not slower. He doesn't not catch everything that comes his way. He's not bad at football.
No.
He's the most dependent player on the field for everybody else. Right. He's the number one receiver in this offense. Look at Dante Moncrief. What's he done? Nobody other than Jack Doyle, which is a new quarterback's best friend, nobody did anything on the Colts this year at all. Lost
horrible
season.
Offensive line.
Lost season.
Receivers all over the place.
Yeah.
So and we talked about it at the beginning of this whole podcast about how this is a very end middle. This is a codependent situation here, and you know, really to have Brissett throwing in the ball, a guy who literally got there in the middle of the season and knows nothing, he still finishes as a top 30 receiver.
Yeah,
I mean, you know,
average 17 yards a catch. Yeah,
you could have been using him all year long for the most part.
There were games where you had. I mean, there was a. I remember specifically he had been on my bench for 2 or 3 weeks in a row, and then they come home. Brissett had looked good the week before, and I got him at a good home game against a weak defense, and he got me like 28 or something. It was hard. So, a lot of these numbers came in one or two games because just it was a hard season for him, and it's just nowhere to put a bow on it.
Guys like T.Y. and a lot of these guys that we have talked about at times can be rather boom or bust, and the reason that we like some of these other guys above him is because we think some of that boom or bust is taken out because they can do some other thing. But with T.Y., like, you kind of, the ranking was, it was really high coming into the season because it was finally, all that had been removed. He had 90 catches. There was no more like games where it was like, oh, well, he had 2 for 20.
Good point.
You know?
Good point.
So
that's exactly what happened. And then this year with the terrible situation, look, 7 for 153 and a touch against Cleveland. The home game I was just talking about that happened was they went up to Seattle and didn't play good, but Brissett looked like a legit quarterback, and I was like, oh my god, they got Brissett, good for the Colts. He comes back home and plays against the Niners, 7 for 177. Later in the season he goes 5 for 175 and 2 against Houston, which came out of nowhere.
Yeah,
like there's a bunch of 2 for 15s and 1 for 19s on this list, but when it happens big for T.Y. because again, it goes, he's top shelf upside. And what happened in 2016 is exactly what Casey just said. He ironed out the floor, and he and Luck were on the same page, and he got 90. Yeah. There were
Everyone
no more
was like,
two
oh, well,
20.
I'm all in now that I can get 91 receptions.
If you take the 2 for 20 off the board, which is exactly what Landry has, off hit that 2 for 20 is not even out there for Landry. Those are that your safety. You pull that floor up, and you keep a high ceiling like T.Y., and that's why he's top 10 last year. 5 for 75 and 2, like not many players can ever get those types of games, and those happen all the time for T.Y., and he's just had a bunch of really bad games this year, and with a ridiculously bad offense. It's a
terrible situation.
In a spot where their defense could literally come out there and be like, just bracket T.Y., don't give up the big play, and we're going to win. It's the Colts.
Yeah.
So the T.Y. Hiltons of the world need to have Luck come back healthy and see what happens next year.